3作目のアズカバンの囚人までは作品中に愛の描写がないハリーポッターシリーズ。しかし4作目炎のゴブレットからは主人公たちが本格的に思春期に入るので異性に興味を持つ姿が演出され始めます。
ダン、ルーパット、トム、all of the kids are no longer 11, 10, 11, 12 years old. And as a result, they are able to draw upon their own romantic mishaps. And I think it makes their performances just that much more real.
8作のうちいろんなキスシーンがありますが、今日はそのキスシーンのメイキング秘話を紹介します。はじめはハリーとチョーです。映画版では4作目から登場し、初登場からお互いを意識する姿を見せてくれます。しかし、今作でチョーはハリーとつながらず、セドリックと恋愛関係に発展します。しかし、セドリックはピーターによって殺害されるので、5作目の不死鳥の騎士団でのチョーはダンブルドア軍団に入り、教師役のハリーから訓練を受けながら2人は恋愛関係に発展、雇り木の下でハリーとキスを交わします。このシーンを撮るとき2人はとても緊張してたそうです。人生初キスだったのかは分かりませんが、みんなの前でしなければならない、カメラ前でのキスは初めてだったからでしょう。
I felt incredibly like self-conscious because really very shy.
Because we were both nervous and we both knew we were nervous, it made it a lot easier, if you know what I mean, because we both knew how we felt and we were both a bit...
Sorry, I think my glasses hit you that time, sorry.
It's quite a clinical sort of thing because you'd sort of be in the kissing position and someone would say, Dan, move to your right. All right. And you'll sort of do that. And it's just a very odd thing to do.
When I say now...You'll just start to kiss on the other side. So you'll just swivel around, yeah?
I mean, it would be a nightmare if you're actually kissing someone and someone said, move to your left! It would be bizarre.
ここで顔を入れ替えながらキスしたのは監督の指示だったんですね。監督やスタッフたちは2人はまだ学生だし、緊張しているのに気づき、撮影現場に少人数だけ残したりする配慮が見られます。
With the Harry and Joe kiss, I don't think many people came on set because both me and Katie were...Quite a bit nervous about it, I think.
You just let yourselves go, completely relax.
They made sure that the set was closed and there was minimal people inside. And they sort of dimmed the lights. I don't know if it was so it would be less intimidating or if it was going to be more romantic.
特にプロデューサーはダニエルを10歳から見てきたので、まるで息子の恋愛をこっそり見ているようで、見てはいけない場面を見ている感じだったと言いました。
It's a very odd thing to watch because it's kind of like watching your own children, but it's not. But you still feel a great sort of paternal instinct.
Good night to Dan and Katie. Well done, guys.
Much of the crew has been on the film since Dan was 10, 11 years old. And to see him now going through this romantic moment was rather beautiful and wonderful, but at the same time, you felt like you shouldn't be in the room watching.
最初は気まずかったけど、2人は慣れてお互いのキスについてこう言いました。
It was a bit awkward at the beginning, but you know, the more we did it, the more we just got used to it, and it was fine.
It's
fine now.
I know, it's cool now, and it's like, yeah. We're really cool.
It was actually great, it was really, really cool, and I'm sure, you know, anyone who's seen the film will agree that Katie's quite beautiful, so I felt very privileged, really.
I'll not kiss you enough today, but I thought that's a...
Daniel is a very good kisser. Thank God.
ありゃ、ダニエル、もしかして初キスではなかったのでは？動画撮影に興味がある人は知っていると思いますが、シーンというのは1回撮って終わりではなく、同じシーンを角度を変えて何回も撮るのが一般的。例えばこのシーンは3つの角度から撮ったので NG がなかったことを前提で少なくとも3回以上キスを繰り返したってことです。メイキング映像で言及されてないんですが、トリビア集にある情報によると、チョーを演じたケイティはダニエルとのキスシーンがあるということで、とても緊張して何週間も準備したそうです。しかし、キスシーン撮影当日、ダニエルが緊張しすぎたせいか病気にかかって撮影が延期になったそうです。ちなみに、このシーンを撮る時の2人の年齢は16歳、18歳でした。
Well, then we've done it now. It's done. There we go.
一作目のジニーは9と4分の3番線でお兄ちゃんたちをお見送りするシーンでちょっとだけ出演しますが、2作目から本格的に登場。映画序盤、ハリーを意識する姿を見せてくれます。
Hello.
また本作で重要な役割を担当し、2人の関係は深くなりますが、3作目と4作目ではまたちょっとだけ出演、5作目で出演が増えますが、ハリーとチョーの関係にスポットライトが当てられていたので、ハリーとジニーの関係はあまり描写されず、6作目の謎のプリンスから急に2人の関係が発展し始めます。そして2人のキスシーンも今作で出ますよね。面白いのは、ジニーを演じたボニーは今作で一番最初に撮ったシーンがこのキスシーンだったそうです。なのでこの後ずっとハリーを演じたダニエルを意識したそうです。
It was actually the first scene I filmed, so I think that added to the kind of build up of what it was to be like, but I think it's difficult to kind of prepare yourself because you'll never know what it's like until it's over.
またダニエルはボニーとのキスがケイティとは違う気分だったらしいです。ケイティとは4、5作目を一緒に撮影したので高校の友達という感じだったのが、ジニーは10歳の時1作目から一緒にやってきたので、まるで幼なじみとキスした気分だったのでしょう。
That was kind of odd, because when Katie Leung as Cho was cast, she was brought in and we were already aware she ultimately was the love interest. Whereas Bonnie, it was kind of odd, because I've known Bonnie since she was about 10. So it's a bit weird doing all that, but it's fine.
Dan's known Bonnie for a long time and then having to kind of...kiss someone. It's quite a weird thing to have to do, so I think everyone's kind of tried to cut each other some slack and just kind of give everyone the space to kind of try and do a good job, I think.
I was talking with other people about kind of all those different things, you know, eat loads of garlic and fish and different things, but that's really cruel, so I did not for that one.
キリッジで大活躍し、みんなに看護されるロンがラベンダーとキスするシーン、ダニエルはこの瞬間をとても待ちに待っていたそうです。なぜなら自分の時の復讐をしたかったからです。
I was very much excited about Ron's scenes with Lavender because I took a fair bit of stick when I kissed Katie in the last film, so it was time for revenge this time around.
ダニエルはスリザリンかも。
Daniel Radcliffe was definitely there. His presence was known on the kissing scene day. I think he even came back when he wasn't on camera just to be there.
You know, I took days to calm down. I don't think Rupert had done a kissing scene. That was entirely new territory for him.
ロンを演じたルパートは、自分の場合はダニエルとは全然違って、数回しか見たことない俳優だったし、周りに何十人もいるからもっと緊張する状況だったと言います。
Well, he was actually quite lucky because when he did his scene, he was on his own. He was just him and Katie. This time in the scene, it's pretty packed, so a little bit more embarrassing, I think. But I just had to try and get over it.
I was quite self-conscious at first. I mean, they do so many takes. By the time we got to like take 20, it was nothing.
それに比べてラベンダーを演じたジェシーは、自分の撮影3回目ですぐキスシーンを撮ったけど、むしろ周りにみんながいたから何も考えずに楽にできたと言いました。
To walk onto a set on actually my third day and to walk into a kissing scene with all of these extras I had to just kind of go on autopilot to handle it. I wasn't really aware of the fact that there would be around 70 or 80 extrasBut actually, I think that probably made it easier.
二人の間ではいろんなことがありました。しかし最終的に一緒に危機を克服した二人は真の愛に気づき、秘密の部屋でキスを交わしますが、実際にはずっとつぼっていたそうです。10年も一緒にやってきたので、まるで兄弟とキスする感じで、キスの予定を聞いた瞬間から2人はとても緊張してたらしいです。
So I'll have a look at it, because we're doing the kiss this week between Ron and Hermione.
What?
Doing the kiss between Ron and Hermione in
this week
in the Chamber of Secrets.
I was dreading it, to be honest.
You are not allowed to be. Everyone was there for my kiss.
I think just because I've known her for so long, it's kind of like 10 years.
If someone is literally like a sibling to you, you've grown up with them, being put in a situation where you have to kiss them is just really awkward.
かわいそうなダニエル。監督は何度も失敗する2人のため、演技のアドバイスをしてあげます。
And I just said to Rupert, don't be Rupert, forget Rupert, just be Ron. Just let Ron take over.In that moment. And I said the same thing to Emma. Let Hermione take over in that moment.
その瞬間、エマは時間を延ばして何度もやり直したくなかったので、むしろ全集中で挑みます。
We'd get it. I saw her make the decision in her eyes. I saw her think, I'm gonna have to really go for it.
I just kind of had to put the incredible amount of history that I have with Rupert aside and be Hermione.Doing it, they're in a huge amount of danger. They've nearly just died, and I think in that moment, it's about both of them realizing if we're gonna die tonight, the one thing I actually want to do is kiss you.
Once we did it, it was nice.
That was great. We got it.
Yes! It's quite romantic, really. It was good. He's a nice kisser.
笑いが止まなかった撮影でしたが、今までのキスシーンの中では一番 NG が少ない6回だけカメラを回したといいます。ハリーとジニーが10回、ロンとラベンダーが20回、ハリーとチョーが30回くらいテイクを繰り返したそうです。最後にハリーとハーマイオニーのキスシーンです。映画では幻影として演出されたシーンだったので本物のキスではなかったのですが、これを撮るために2人は実際にキスをしたらしい。メイキング映像はないんですが、トリビア集によると2人は裸ではなくジーンズを履いていて、エマはストラップなしのブラをつけて撮影に挑んだそうです。監督は霧ではっきり見えない演出だから裸で撮影する必要がなかったと言います。裸ではなかったけどブラだけだったのでメイキング映像がないことに納得できますね。はい、今日はハリーポッターのキスシーントリビアを見てみました。皆さんどうでしたか？動画が面白かったらチャンネル登録、いいね、コメントぜひお願いします。ちなみにハリーポッターシリーズはこちらの動画配信サイトで見られます。今日の動画はここまでです。次回もお楽しみに。バイバーイ。